Good morning, everybody. I am heading out to a new job to start ripping out some old ductwork and a couple systems. I'm gonna start with the downstairs and do the upstairs. So pretty big job for a one-man show, and for most of it's gonna be just one man, so it'll be a nice long-winded job here right after Thanksgiving. But we're gonna get started today ripping out some old Heil units we've seen in some of the service videos and start yanking out some ductwork. Fun!
These are our two units here. About to recover all the refrigerant out of this one, which is for downstairs. Take out the electrical and all that. Take out the old whip, because we're going to replace it and everything. We have a nice panel right there that's still okay. We definitely need to replace those old sun-dried whips. So I'm going to get started and get this thing off the house. Our old heat pump is gone. Electrical whip is gone. Sitting mounted by the truck out there. About time to go into the crawl space and start taking the air handler apart. And then moving on to the ductwork.
Looking up into the crawl space there, you can see there's some trunk duct laid on the ground. There's a larger turn duct right there, flex, black flex. Air handler used to be right there. Clearing all of it out, it's a job. Slowly but surely, I should have all the trunk duct out here in a few minutes. Then I'll move on to the flex duct.
Here's some of our duct work here. We have the return flex on top and our supply trunk on the bottom there. It's only about, let's see, looks like 25 foot long or so. Take it to the dump, we have to strip off the insulation down to the metal and crush it, which is what we're going to do today, perhaps today. And right now I'm breaking the flex apart. And putting it into the bags to throw away.
Alright guys, we have our truck all loaded up. We have the heat pump, air handler in the back, several trash bags, and only ones we had left. Actually got all that pipe. We have a grand total of 5 bags left over here, so not too bad. We get to work on Wednesday, putting the new air handler in, new heat pump, line set, and start with the duct work, and then hopefully finish that up on Friday. Now I'm sitting in my truck after tearing out that duct system all by my lonesome, and I made the mistake of going to Burger King and having 2 double cheeseburgers and some chicken nuggets, and I feel like I could fall asleep. But unfortunately, the work day is over, but not the family part of the day. So I had to press on for a little bit longer, but I will be happy tonight when I finally hit the bed. And we'll pick up on this job again on Wednesday when I move on to dropping the boots out of the floor, which I left in place. Replacing those and probably getting the air handler and heat pump in place instead of just leaving the duct system on Friday. See you then. Well, it was a long day, and I was about to have a few more long days because I had planned on getting some help on this job, but it didn't work out. We had a couple miscommunication issues, so it would end up that I'd be doing this job by myself. But that's okay. I was very proud once I got done. I was able to do everything the way I wanted, and the system looked real good. But you have to stick around and see the rest of that. I am back on site, guys. Got my equipment up there. Got my nuts and washers. I'm going to build a Unistrut base for the air handler in the crawl space so we can hang it from the joist. And once I get that done, I'll show y'all what I did, and we'll go on from there. We have the air handler sitting in place, hung on Unistrut 3/8 all thread rod. We have a media filter here. Take a closer look. There's the all thread rods hangers. Unistrut placed under the unit, 2 rows about 1 inch in on either side of the unit, and we have cork pads underneath it to isolate some vibration so it doesn't transmit to the floor. So there we are. There's the air handler in all its glory. I've run the line set underneath it. I'm about to fit it up and then set the outdoor unit. That way I can turn the nitrogen on and then braze everything at one time. And we'll be well on our way, slowly but surely. The copper's all fitted up. The good thing about having the benders, we come up underneath the unit, we can make a bend going up and then another bend going into the unit. The 3/8 is pretty easy to bend by hand. Normally I'll just bend it by hand because there's no point in taking out a bender for 3/8. But for 3/4 it makes it look real nice. Gives you nice smooth turns. And just dresses up the whole job. So I'm going to go set the outdoor unit. And then I can braze all these in after I get them fitted up inside and out.
The Bryant 2.5-ton heat pump is in place outside. 13 sear. We have our risers underneath it. Just get a little bit of height to keep it clean. We're about to fit up the copper piping. Turn the nitrogen on and braze both the indoor and outdoor.
I have the copper fitted up on the outdoor unit. This one is loose here, the liquid line. What I'm doing is I'm going to put nitrogen in through the suction port, run it back toward the air handler, and it'll come back, the liquid line, and just blow out the end of this tube harmless. So I'm going to go ahead and braze this up. I actually forgot to put the dryer in underneath, so I'm going to go refit that after I get done brazing this. Well, guys, it's the end of day 2. Air handler's in place. Got our media filter, got the lines brazed in, got a pressure test on the lines, squared arounds on. When I come back on Friday, we're going to try to knock out as much of the duct system as possible. Put the boots in. I'm going to try a new sealing method with the boots to use foam around them. So that's going to slow things down a little bit, but hopefully it's a better job. But here we go, all done. So I'll be back on Friday to try to complete the task or come close.
Unfortunately, since it's a one-man business, at the end of the day, I had to drive about 40 miles north to a small town called Rose Hill to do a service call and a combustion analysis on a brand new Amana gas furnace. But that's how it goes, and that's how we get our money. So I'll take it anytime. So we're going to take our trip up there, probably be there around nightfall, knock it out, and head on home for the day.
I'm in between calls here, guys. I just put up a new Honeywell 8000, an indoor sensor, or a wireless indoor sensor. Now I'm about to go do some combustion analysis as the sun goes down. Kind of a pretty scene, kind of eerie almost. All right, guys, well, I am heading out to the job. It's Friday. The downside is I'm a little bit sick. I got sick yesterday and it's pretty much gone into today. So I've changed the schedule a little bit. I'm not going to be able to finish the entire job today just because it's just going to be too much crawling through the crawl space. But I am going to do the boots, foam the boots, get those going so I can have some progress going forward the next week, complete the job. Because in North Carolina right now it's pretty mild, so there's no, the homeowner's fine with it. And in fact, the homeowner had kept their unit shut off for like a month before I got there. So a little bit downside of running your own business, but we'll get on it, keep going forward, and the next week wrap things up. But on with the show. Well, I got my Flex. There's some boots in the box over here. My Reflectix, I'm gonna wrap those boots, put some insulation on them. First, I gotta go drop a couple boots out of the floor. We'll put those boots up in there and see if we can foam the bottom, see how well that works. Look around the crawl space, you can see our new line set down there. And some more of the Flex runs. We'll take a closer look at the boot now, see how it's mounted to the floor. As you see, our Flex run, 8-inch R8, runs up to the floor there. And we look up a little bit closer, we can see it's stuck through the floor. On each side, it's nailed. I use roofing tacks most of the time. And then I put a little bead of expansion foam around it, and it'll expand and fill the cracks. Watching out not to put too much expanding foam on it, or else it will fill the cracks and then some and crush your boot. Does a good job, because you can't always reach all four sides. You can also seal it from the top. I just choose to try it this way. I'm trying to do a little bit better job as far as sealing for all possible air leaks. That's the climate we live in now, so I'm trying to do the best job I can in that regard. So that's pretty much done for today. Got the boots in place, got Flex tied onto them, got the thermostat in place upstairs, and the return grill and floor grills. So I am done for today. I'm not feeling well anyway, so I'm gonna take off and go home and rest and hit this again next week to finish it off in one day. All right, guys, I'm back at my shop. I reinforced my cold medication, so I'm gonna make my box for the job for the back of the air handler itself. So I'm going to get that done before I go back next week just to have one more thing out of the way so I don't have to make it on site or buy a box because they cost so much more than it costs to make one. So that's what I'm doing now here at the break table. And here's a very fast look at that. Overnight, a little rainstorm came, so I had to cover things up with a tarp because I wanted to make sure I was loaded up, because it's hard to load everything up in the morning. You lose so much time. So I put a tarp over the truck and make sure the rain doesn't get on some of my stuff. Most of the stuff won't be bothered by it, but a few of the items might be ruined. So after I get the tarp off here, I can head back to the job and we can get started trying to finish this thing up. I'm back out at the job. I got my snap-lock pipe here. This is 12 inch, some 16 there and some 10. 10's not put together. I've already put the 16 in. I brought some extra from the house. Always good to reuse, good for the budget. So I have one section of 16 inch trunk in place. I'm making a section of 12 and then I'm reducing down to 10. And I'll take you guys underneath and take a look at it here in a moment. I'm in the crawl space now. I have finished the supply trunk as far as getting the main duct in place. I have the square around there, got an elbow going downward. Then it runs about 35 feet way on down there. And what I'm doing now is I'm gonna go do the runouts and do the seams where I put the pipes together and insulate those. Moving right along, slowly but surely. We start off with a 16 inch pipe. It reduces down after 8 foot to 12. The reason being why it reduces from 16 to 12 is that we have these 2/8 coming off and there's 3/6 on the other side. So a high percentage of our airflow is already dissipated by the time we leave this 8 foot section. And then we switch down to 12, which carries roughly 600 CFM plus or minus. Run another 10 feet, take another couple runs off of it. Then it reduces down to 10. And it runs 15 feet to catch the last four. So that's pretty much it. A lot of duct system for one dude. And I'm gonna try to do all the runouts, see if I can finish those as well. And then I have the return box and return flex to move on to if I can get to that today. Well, I'm on the last takeoff on this side of the duct. I've done, let's see, 6 runouts so far. Here's number 7 on this side, and then all the other ones are on the other side. So yippee, tie those in. What we'll do is we put the flex onto this piece, which I call takeoff. Has a damper on the inside with a manual handle on top. Use a UL-181B tape on the inside. Use silver on the outside. Wrap Panduits on the inside and outside, and you are good to go. So there's quite a little procedure. Back in the day it was a little simpler, but now there's more specifics involved. That's what I'm doing. All this is R8. Hopefully it'll never turn to R10 or there won't be any room for it any longer. So that's what I'm working on now. About just over halfway through. Well guys, it's getting dark outside, as you can see. It's getting real dark in the crawl space. I have finished all the trunk duct today, all the runouts. Run the return within about 4 feet of the box on the back of the unit. It is not quite long enough, but we are about to wrap it up tomorrow. Pretty good day, pretty full day. I might have to put this one on my resume. Day of the year. But everything's looking good. Also sealed up the tape on the outside with a little bit of mastic sealant. Prevent it from falling off over the years. Well, that's about it for today. Tomorrow we'll be starting things up. And hopefully a happy, happy day. And a happy, happy pay. Alright guys, this looks like the last day of system number 1, and I can now officially say that I've installed a system from start to finish, from line set to boots to flex to trunk to everything, or I will be able to say it in a few hours. I have to finish my return duct and start the system up, and we'll be good to go, and I'll be a happy camper. I have my return runaround spliced onto my piece I had at the shop. Thank God. Saves you $70 when you save a little bit of flex at the shop. I'm running my drain out to the outside wall.
Before, the drain came down way low, so I'm trying to put a hole a little bit higher. I can only go about 4 inches higher. And I have my Harbor Freight hammer drill to help me. I've had this drill for about 2 years now. I only use it a handful of times, so I don't use it a whole lot. But for the price, which I think was like $79 or something, it has outlasted its worth for sure. I have a 1-inch bit, but I really needed one that's a little bit larger, so I had to chisel it out at the end there. But everything is through. It is tight. Very, very tight. So I'm going to connect that drain, and we're almost ready to vacuum and start up. All right, guys, I have finished up the drain. I'm about to head inside after I turn the power on, configure the thermostat, put the system in a vacuum. This is my, let's see, it is a dual-port manometer from Philips. I'll be doing static pressure with this. The manometer comes with all this stuff except for the static pressure probes, which I bought online. One of those little AC online parts houses. But they're only like 25 bucks, so it's not too bad. But I'll be using those to confirm airflow. We have our vacuum running. We're down to 34 microns. Of course, that's not the true reading. I'll valve off the pump. The reading will rise. We'll let it sit here for a few minutes, see if it gets above 1,000. If not, I'm happy. If so, we'll keep going. Okay guys, a few minutes have passed. We're only up to 393, so I think we're pretty good here. I'm going to go ahead and release the refrigerant, hook up the I-manifold, and start the system.
Guys, I have the I-manifold hooked up to the system. As you see, I have my red hose here. It's on the hot discharge line, because we're going to be testing it in heat. On the flip side over there, we have the blue hose on. We actually have a piston right here, so we're actually going to get suction pressure right here. You can get it from there or the heat charging port, but we'll just take it from right there, because it's a little bit easier.
The system's now started. We're running in heat mode. Let's take a look at the pressures right now. As you can see them on the screen, I'm gonna put them up there, a picture from the I manifold. See, the heat pressures are still rising. Heat strips are running. It was 62 degrees inside the house. So it's kind of a cool house. We'll let it run for a little while. And now we'll take a look at our static pressure readings.
Our static pressure reading right now is about 0.54. At 0.54, according to our blower chart, we'll have anything from 900 to 1,000 CFM, depending on if we choose tap 4 or 5. We have tap 4 as a regular call for fan and tap 5 as a heat strips, because I do not want to put the heat strips on tap 4 and the regular call on tap 5. So we're going to be below the nominal 400 CFM slightly, but right in the ballpark of where we should be.
Alright guys, we have our air handler, the FB4C30. We have tap 5 at top and tap 4 right below that. If we go over here, look down to 0.5, which is here. We have 1,009 at tap 5 and 899 at tap 4. So basically we're getting 900 CFM theoretically on tap 4 right now and 1,000 on tap 5, which is the emergency heat running. A very popular question that I get is, how do you charge a heat pump in heating mode? Well, most of the heat pumps will have a charging chart on the inside of them, and that's how what we're going to look at to charge this one. Let's take a closer look at the heat pump charging chart, see if we can figure out if we're onto something or way off. Now, we are the 030 size there, and we have a 60, 70, and 80 on the side. It's indoor dry bulb. Now, we're right in between those two, so we're going to have to sort of, you know, interpolate what we're going to do there. Outside, we have 60 degrees, which is going to be the highest number on our chart. So we're looking in between these two right here in the middle. We have a high pressure of 368 and a high pressure of 410. Low pressure of 127 and 130. Now we're above that on the low pressure, and we're slightly below that on the high pressure, as we can see from the I-manifold pressure readings. We'll let it go for a few more minutes, and I'm betting we're going to end up in between these two. As you see from the picture of the I-manifold, we have got a little bit closer to in between the two numbers. We've passed the first.
And we'll most likely line up right in the middle where I won't mess with it any until we recharge in the spring if we want to check it in air conditioning. Everything looks pretty good. Everything working well. I'll be moving on to the upstairs system soon. But as for charging, we are about done.
Well, guys, I finished up the first part of our job here. 2.5 ton, 13 sear split system. I was going to head out to a service call, but I called the fella about 3 hours ago, and he still hasn't called me back. So he is shit out of luck for today. And if he calls back, he'll be on for Friday. And this is Wednesday. So, oh well. Tomorrow I have a couple service calls. And then Friday, I don't know quite what's going to happen yet. Depends on if this fella calls me back or we get some more service calls. And then I'll be back on Monday to start the upstairs, which is a 2-ton split system, which will also be zoned. So, should be a lot of fun. We'll get to see some of the zone controls. I'm not sure whether I'm going to use EcoJ or Honeywell at this point, but I might try Honeywell. I don't use them a whole lot for zoning, so we'll see. We'll compare prices. But we'll pick up on that. Maybe show a little bit of the in-between while we're going through it.